Hello students, in today's lecture we'll be looking at the ADC module of PIC18. So ADCs are used for converting analog signals to digital signals. Now if you see our environment around us, it is in analog form. We need to convert into the digital form so that we are able to control it. Take your example of your fridge or your AC. Here the temperature is the analog, which is converted into a digital using some sensors. So you will have an analog value which will be measured by a sensor or a transducer, which will convert into an electrical form. So this can be temperature, pressure, any elements, and this will be converted into electrical form, and through the ADC it will be converted into the digital form where I can process it and we can take some action. So let us see the block diagram of the ADC. Now here you can see this is the common block diagram of an ADC. Now the ADC is decided by the resolutions. So we have 8-bit, 10-bit, 12-bit and up to 21-bit of ADCs. So that means I can have, if I say 8-bit, I can have 256 levels, digital levels. If I have 10-bit, I have 1024 levels. And if I have 12-bit, that is I can have 4096 levels, digital levels. Now here the analog input will be within some range. So analog input here generally is from 0 to 5 volts or 0 to 10 volts, or sometimes in some of the ADC we can even have minus 5 to plus 5 volts. Now the binary data over here is decided by the bits or the resolution. Now this analog to digital mapping is decided by the resolution as well as the V reference over here. So V reference will provide the scale. So V reference will tell you, V plus V reference will give you what is the maximum mapping to the digital value. So here if it is the maximum value of the digital, and minus V reference will tell you the minimum value of the digital that will be mapped, right? And then we have the signal called as the start of conversion, which will start the conversion from analog to input to digital input, and it will take some time. So it's not an instantaneous process, it will take some time. So when you have an ADC, you need to look at this major characteristics. So let us look at the characteristics one by one. What is resolution? So when we talk about an ADC, it is the smallest step size that I can detect. Okay, that is the smallest analog step size that I can detect. Okay, now it is dependent on the resolution of the ADC, which is fixed. The resolution of the ADC is fixed, but the V reference I can play around. So this can be varying. So by changing the V reference, I can now change the resolution of the ADC. Conversion time. This conversion time is the time taken to convert from analog to digital, and it can be depends upon the ADC. So it can be sometimes in microseconds range. It is mostly in the microseconds range. V reference is the, so you have plus V reference and minus V reference. So here both the V reference decides the scale or mapping of analog value to digital value. Now let us look at how we can do the resolution. So let us look at the resolution calculation. So let us say I have a 10-bit ADC. So I have a 10-bit ADC. That means I can have 0 to 1023, that is 1024 levels. Now that means if I use V reference is equal to 5 volts, that means 5 volts I can detect any step size of say 5 millivolt, approximately 5 millivolt, right? Now what can happen is I can detect now 0 millivolt, 5 millivolt, 10 millivolt, 15 millivolt and 20 millivolt. So, and so on and so forth from 0 to 1024. So this digital value is mapped like this. Okay. And 1024 will be mapped to 5 volts. Okay. 2.5 volt will be somewhere around 512, something like that. So this is 1:1 mapping. Now the point is, if I want to detect 3 millivolts, it is not possible over here, right? Because I can only detect 0 millivolt, 5 millivolt or 10 millivolt. 3 millivolt is not at all detectable. So how we can do that? Either we can go for a higher order ADC, or I can go for V reference equal to say 3 volts. Now when 3 volts, this is approximately equal to somewhere around 3 millivolts. Okay. So I am not taking the decimal point into consideration to make it understandable and very simple. Now what will happen is we will change the mapping. So here the mapping has now changed, right? So here for V reference 5 volts. Now let us see for V reference 3 volts. So here the zero, digital zero corresponds to zero, but here the one corresponds to 3 millivolts. Now I can detect 3 millivolts, 6 millivolts, 9 millivolts and 1024 will now go to 3 volts, right? Now in the previous case, you can see the scale is higher. I can detect any voltage from 0 to 5 volts. But by changing the V reference now to 3 volts, I can only detect from 0 to 3 volts, but the resolution has improved. So to 512 will come to 1.5 millivolts, somewhere around 1.5 millivolts, right? So by playing around with the V reference as well as the ADC. Now, if I don't want to change the V reference, I want to have the scale of 5 volts itself. I need to go for a 12-bit ADC. So in this case, what will happen? We will have 5 volt divided by, so 12-bit ADC is 0 to 4095, that is 4096 level. So I have 4096, right? So this is 1/4 of this, that is 1.2 millivolt. So as you can see, I can detect much better step size compared to the previous one when I increase the resolution of the ADC, and the scale also remains same. So here you can see the scale. So I can detect from 0 to 5 volt with an accuracy of a step size of 1.2 millivolts by having a 12-bit ADC, right? Now let us look at the PIC18F4520 registers. Here we have a 10-bit ADC. So PIC18 has a 10-bit ADC with somewhere around 13 channels. You can see we have 13 channels. So I can connect 13 sensors to it, but there is only one ADC module. Try to understand this. There is only one ADC, but 13 channels are present through something called as an analog multiplexer. Now by using this register or by selecting any of these bits, I can select any of the channel and subsequently any of the sensor that I want to convert from analog to digital value. Now I have to switch on the ADC by using this bit. This bit becomes 1 if I switch on the ADC. Now here is an interesting case. This go is the start conversion signal. This is both the start conversion and end of conversion signal. So when I write a 1 to it, the ADC will sample, or it will sample and hold the analog value on the channel that I have selected, and then it will convert. After conversion, this bit will be cleared. This bit will be cleared to indicate that the ADC conversion has been done. Here you can see the pins. Now maybe for some of the pins, we may not require all the 13 channels. We may require only say 1 or 2 channels. So in this case, we don't require the other pins to be analog pins. So this configuration, these bits will ensure that which pins are analog pins and which pins are, or which channels are enabled and which channels are disabled. Okay. So here you can see that by making it all 000, the pins becomes analog pins. And at reset, you please remember, at reset, most of the pins are at analog value, right? Now, if I make all this 1, it will become digital value. So these are all digital. So if I make it all 1, it will become digital. Now, depending upon how many channels you require, you can put the value into it. So if I only require 1 channel, you can write 1110 into it and you will have only 1 channel. If you want to write 2 channels, you have to write the subsequent code to it, right? Now here the voltage configuration will decide whether we want the V reference or we want the plus V reference and the negative V reference. Okay. So if it is zero, it is connected to the minus V reference is always connected to ground and the plus V reference is connected to VCC. Otherwise, it is given to pin number AN2, channel number AN2 and AN3 will work as the negative as well as the positive V reference. Now, since it is 10-bit ADC, the 10-bit ADC can be made up of two bytes, right? So here it's an 8-bit register. So we have the ADRF, ADRESL and the ADRESH, that is the register where the 10-bit data will come. Now, if I say write justified, what will happen is you will have the 8-bit ADC data and the 2-bit ADC data written like this when ADFM is equal to 1. But when ADFM is equal to 0, what will happen is this is the 8-bit ADRESH with the MSB and the lower two bits will be written into this. This is the format for ADFM is equal to 0 and this is for the format for ADFM is equal to 1. So how the data is split is decided by this bit, right? Now after this, what is the acquisition time? So what time you want to wait for the acquisition to happen, right? So we can have 20 clocks, 12, 16 or any values. Generally it is kept at 0. We can also decide the ADC clock. The ADC works, since it is a synchronous device, it requires a clock. So there is an internal RC clock that is always provided to it, or you can provide our external clock or oscillator clock to it divided by the particular value. Now please try to understand that there are some limitation to the clock that I can provide. Generally it is up to 512 kilohertz. So the clock, final clock value should not exceed 512 kilohertz. Okay. So accordingly find out the dividing factor. But generally most of the time we use the internal ADC clock for conversion. Now this is the block diagram to give you an idea of how the ADC works. So here any of the sensors can be connected, right? Any of the sensors can be connected. This two, AN3 and AN2, has special function because you can use it also as V reference, plus or minus V reference. Here these channels are selected. Any of this channel selected, that channel analog output will come over here. It will go into a sample and hold circuit. When we start conversion, this analog value will be held and it will be converted into 10-bit, right? So we have seen that in an ADC we can control the resolution using V reference plus or minus V reference, but it will change the scale also. It will change the scale. Understand that it will change the scale. Second is we have a 10-bit ADC in PIC18, right? Then we can select the channel. So we have 13 channels. And we can configure it anyhow we want. Then we can have selectable V reference range, right? So with this, we have looked at the ADC part of the PIC18. Now we'll look at some of the labs later in the lecture. Thank you and happy learning.